and welcome to The One Show with Alex Jones.
And Matt Baker.
Now, tonight, 101 reasons to watch the show. There they are.
They're not just a pretty face, as Joe Ingles finds out.
Absolutely gorgeous. And we're joined by a singer who's all things nice.
Both sporty and spice, it's Melanie C.
Thank you, Melanie.
To offer our guests a little drink, you know. Usually it's water. You're lucky it's wine tonight.
Right,
but
yes.
Can you tell the difference between these two bottles of wine here?
One of them is fake.
Let's have a look.
OK, there we are. Look, that's as far as we can go.
Oh, sorry.
There we are.
Well, on first look, no. They both look...
Have another look. Have a second look.
No, they both look pretty, yeah.
Right.
They look identical, don't they?
I'll give you the answer, shall I? I'll give you the answer. It's this one. You can tell by the level. It's just a little bit further down. This does happen to be Jacob's Creek. It is happening with lots of other wines. We have to point that out. But,
yeah. Well, trading standards have seen a worrying increase in the manufacture of counterfeit alcohol.
Yeah, but what may seem like a bargain at the time can leave you with a sore head, as Joe Crowley found out.
The thing about counterfeit booze, you have no idea what chemicals you're putting into your body. It could be extremely damaging to your health. Sobering stuff.
Incredible. You do have to be so careful. Do you know, I've got a little story about homebrew.
Go on.
I was on the Trans-Siberian Express, right, and around the world in 80 days, and the bloke in the next carriage invited me through and said, have a little drink of this. So I had a couple of them. I don't know what was in it, right? It was unbelievable. So I needed some air. So at the next station, I got off, and I'm standing there, right, with no phone, no wallet, and I'm walking around and the train leaves the station.
What did
and
you
I'm
do?
And I'm stood in the middle of Siberia. With that. Well, I ran after the train, Indiana Jones style, jumped on the train and, well, unbelievable. But there we go. So you've got to be so careful.
It's not like
No, it's not.
To be stranded in Siberia because of vodka.
That's it.
No. Well, anyway, right. Now, you're one busy lady. I mean, you run a triathlon, not only ran it, but came first in the female group.
You starred in
Blood Brothers in the West End, released a fourth album.
Fifth album.
And became mother to lovely Scarlett.
Yes.
So which one of those four things was the most challenging?
I would have to say, and I think all parents would agree,
Yeah,
having a child has to be the most challenging thing because it's just so terrifying. You want to do the right thing and there's a lot to learn and it keeps changing everything, every day.
OK, well, the first single of the new album, The Sea, is out very shortly. So think about it. Let's have a little listen to that.
Great.
And see how it looks. Here we go.
I'm really excited about the whole album, really.
And you look so glamorous. I mean, in the video and on the cover, you're in a skimpy dress. Yeah. Do you think becoming a mother has made you feel a little bit more sexy, maybe?
You know what? I do feel more confident after becoming a mum. I'm sure some of it's getting older as well.
Mm.
But, I'm really enjoying my new role.
Yeah, I tell you, do you know what? I love Week. It's number two,
Week, that's one of my faves.
Do you know, it's a brilliant Paso Doble song. For all the ballroom fans out there,
it's coming in.
And, honestly, it's lovely, really good. But it's called The Sea, and it's in it. It's gone all over.
All of this comes back to Strictly.
What? The Sea, it's quite an interesting name, that then. Why did you choose
The
Sea?
Well, one of my first writing sessions, I was down in Brighton, and each morning I'd walk along the seafront to the studio.
Oh,
and I just found it a really inspiring time, and the opening track is The Sea.
Yeah, you can hear the waves crashing.
Yeah, and actually the waves, interesting story. Am I allowed to hold it up? I don't know.
Yes.
Interesting story. When we did this shoot for the album cover, we were up in Whitby and we recorded the sea, like, coming in, the tide coming in, and we've actually used it on the track.
Cool.
Yes.
And going back to the whole Blood Brothers thing, I mean, you were even nominated for an Olivier Award. Amazing in the role. Have you thought about doing some more theatre?
I would love...
Because you were pretty scared about doing the role initially, weren't you?
I was petrified, yeah. But I felt like... It's funny, after I had my little girl, I felt really courageous. There's this thing where I just feel I want to make her proud of me. So all the things I really wanted to do, but I've always been too frightened to before, I'm thinking, no, I want to do it now. Like the triathlon, working in the theatre. And I had an amazing time. I really didn't know what to expect. I just thought, I want to work really hard, do my best. We got great reviews.
Brilliant reviews.
And yeah, I got a real taste for it. Mm. But I really missed my music, so it was time to make a new record. But in the future, I'd love to do more.
Well, how about Spice Girls the Musical?
I can't wait.
By Jennifer Saunders.
Me too. Well, I actually went to see We Will Rock You last night, which is amazing. Yeah. Absolutely love it. I've always been a big Queen fan. Fantastic cast, great music, great bands, brilliant show. And yeah, it made me get really excited about Spice Girls Musical.
Have you had quite an involvement in that then?
Well, we talked about it for a long time. It was something we always felt that the Spice Girls music would be perfect for a Western show.
Definitely.
So we were, when we spent time together doing the reunion tour in 2007, we were talking a lot about it and decided to, to get proactive, get out there, start meeting some producers. Mm. When we got back, which we started to do when we met Judy Kramer, who produced Mamma Mia, both the stage show and the movie, and she is fantastic. So we thought she's the perfect lady for the job. And then she got Jennifer Saunders on board to write the story, and it's a dream team for us, really. So we're very excited.
And when will it be on the stage?
We're hoping it's going to be finished for the end of next year. So the end of 2012 is the plan.
Very exciting. Oh, yes. And back to the rest of the girls then. You're all mothers by now. Do you still see a lot of each other?
Yeah, we do, We try and see each other as much as we can. Everyone's busy. Two of the girls live over in America now, so sometimes it's tricky.
Yeah.
But I think the children have brought us closer together. We like to try and share birthdays and, spend time together. And all the kids are brilliant, so it's nice.
I'm sure loads of people ask you this, but are you reforming for the Olympics?
I wish. I would love to do it. I've never been approached, so I don't know where the story came from. I don't know if there's any truth in the rumour, but it's never got through to me.
I'm sure they'd love to have you.
I don't know about that, but the Spice Girls musical is definitely happening.
Yes.
So, yeah, get your tracksuits and all your little
union jacks.
Yeah, get on that. Story beautifully told, and we're now enjoying a very civilised cup of tea from Wedgwood.
And we should indeed raise our cups to Josiah Wedgwood, one of the great men of our country.
Cheers.
I mean, he was a social reformer.
He was.
He pioneered, as it were, the fight against slavery, for example. Yeah. And he was an industrial reformer, one of the fathers of the Industrial Revolution.
Yes.
A great man.
Wonderful at technology as well, which you're about to demonstrate.
This is something that he invented. What do you think this is?
Well, in the rehearsal, I did say it looked like a giant Kit Kat to go with it. It's not.
It's a pyrometer invented by Josiah Wedgwood to actually measure the temperature in a kiln. Until he invented this device, there was a character called a kiln man who stood by the kiln saying, yes, I think it's hot enough now to actually have baked the pottery. But sometimes he didn't get it right and the pottery was smashed. This device, in which, as it were, a little globule of the clay is put, and as you will have discovered, I'm sure, in science at school, what happens to clay as it gets hotter, it gets smaller, it contracts, and you can actually measure the temperature by the size of the pottery going down the clay as it went down these little rivulets here. And it's measured in what were known as Wedgwood grades. Centigrade, Wedgwood grade.
Oh, right.
He invented this, and because of this, mass production became possible. It changed the world. And he gave us, of course, creamware that became popular because he sent some to Queen Charlotte, Queen of George III. She loved it, and she said, ooh, I like this. And because the Queen liked it, the middle classes began to adopt it. I'm handling this with care, only because that particular jug is worth some £4,000. The sauce boat, £2,000. I just hope we're insured.
But he could have actually touched that as well, couldn't he?
No, Josiah, this is from the Wedgwood Museum. These items could have been touched by
Josiah. Are you a fan of the creamware, Melanie? Do you like the creamware?
It's very beautiful, yes. I'm very nervous.
Do you have any Wedgwood in your house?
No, I don't think so.
You can take this vase.
I've got lots of IKEA and Habitat.
You're probably the only person at this table who could afford this vase.
Tell us about
this. This is made of jasper ware. And in 1774, after 1,000 experiments, Wedgwood came up with jasperware, a new kind of, well, it was like porcelain, as subtle as porcelain, but actually sturdier. And he, because he was as modern as tomorrow, but had a lot of time for yesterday, this is a recreation of an old Etruscan vase. Actually, once Caesar Augustus had a vase like this, the British Museum had one, and he made a copy of it that would now retail for £100,000 if you could buy it. And in fact, when in the 1800s, the British Museum one was broken. Oops! When it was broken, they used They used Wedgwood's model to recreate it.
Can I just point out Nigel here, who's from the museum, as Giles is waving his arms around, he's sweating and diving like a goalkeeper.
Nigel's over there and the men in the white coats are over there. One's going to take that lot and the other's going to take me, but why not?
But you've bought another collector's item in it.
I have a collector's item for one of my heroines. I felt you needed to have a little bit of Wedgwood in your life, and so, Mel, look what I've got. You.
Oh, wow.
Your own Priceless. Wedgwood plate.
Isn't that lovely?
Priced above rubies.
It's proper Wedgwood.
It's proper Wedgwood.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
But so you have got Wedgwood in your house now.
Made in...
This would cost you 12,000, and this certainly £1.20. Oh, well, no.
We are reliably informed it's worth £16.
Yeah.
There you go.
If it's increase, after the musical, it'll increase.
Brilliant. Wedgwood name lives on. Okay. Perfect.
Thanks so much, Jack. Fabulous.
That was more under control, wasn't it? That was obviously take number four or five. These, however, are very well behaved.
This is Hector and Una.
I'm not sure if my little one's very well behaved.
That's all right. Aww. Oh, that's, bless you. Oh, you're going for a little wander. No. You're doing very well, though, there, Melanie.
They never
that's
work
it,
with
yeah.
children and animals.
Now, these two, they're only 7 weeks old.
Aww.
They're absolutely gorgeous. And I've got a couple of little Dalmatian facts for you. When they're born completely spotless. Pure white. So they don't actually develop their spots until they're about 2 weeks old. They have to have a little hearing test as well.
And we have to say, Mel, you're being pretty brave because you are, in fact, allergic to dogs, aren't you?
Well, I've got my best kecks on as well, so I'm not best pleased about that. Yeah, I'm allergic to dogs, but I'm allergic, actually, to most animals.
Are you?
Yeah. I love animals, so it's a bit of a curse,
It's really tricky.
But do you remember when you came on the show in 2007?
How
we gave
I
you
forget?
Something less cute to hold then.
You did, yes. Last time I was here, I had a tarantula on my hand, which was fine.
Yes, here we go. Look, we've got a little bit of footage about that. You're being very brave, look. Are you
I'm glad
petrified
I didn't wear
inside?
That blouse because I was going to wear that again today. That would have been embarrassing. Oh.
Una. Come on, Una's having a little look at the album down there. She's
you
trying
interested?
To do a lovely plug for you. The 5th of September it's out, isn't it? So it's a very exciting time for you, this.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, can't wait, yeah. Single and the album are out. And, yeah, it's my first in 4 years.
So, and why is it so different, then, to the others? Don't worry about Una. Una's over there. You can let her go,
right.
Honestly.
Let her go.
Yeah, she'll have shall I just pop her down so she doesn't have to take the jump herself? Oh, there you are, my darling.
Have you played the album, Sven, with the others?
Let's look.
I'm trying to think. I think all the girls have heard the single.
Yeah,
Emma loves it. She's been playing bits on Heart. So, yeah.
Handy having a friend on Heart.
It is. Yeah. But, no, it's going great. It's getting really well received at radio. And, yeah, it's an exciting.
Now, before tonight, were you aware that it was Canal Week on the One Show?
I'm sad to say that I wasn't, but I'm...
Where have you been, Mel? Come on.
I know.
Have you ever thought about a boating holiday?
You know what? I've got lots of friends that have done it and had a really fantastic time.
It's brilliant, honestly. So, we get out and about quite a lot on Countryfile. But, anyway...
Okay.